Yeah, I thought you would. Let's get started then. Death row in mate Yod. What's your connection to prisoner D99 detective Yod? He seems like more than just a co-worker. Yes, I suppose you have the right to know. Detective Yod is my hero. Hero, huh? You don't hear that word much anymore? Well, it's an old-fashioned hero kind of story. It happened 10 years ago. Now just calm down and drop that weapon. Stay back. If you come any closer, I'll shoot her. On that day, 10 years ago, I was playing in my favorite park. And then suddenly, somebody grabbed my arm from behind. I was so scared, I thought I was going to die. And then... he appeared, Detective Yod. Ow. And that really loud sound, I think it was the sound of a gun. I passed out. When I came to... You alright now? Are you hurt? You say me, mister? I was just doing my job. The ghost, they're the ones who saved you. What's your job, mister? Me? I'm a police detective. And that's why she wants to be a detective. So that's why you become a detective, huh? That's right, he was my ideal of what a detective was all about. But an ideal detective doesn't shoot and kill his own wife. Exactly. Boink. And that's why I want to prove that he didn't. Point X. Detective Ringe works for the Special Investigation Unit. He said an important deal is set to go down here tonight at the restaurant. A deal that could affect the future of our nation. A nation isn't something that's easily influenced, though. But that's what he said, anyway. It's that couple at the table upstairs. I heard they're foreigners. They're waiting for the other party in this deal to show up. Those two, huh? They certainly are an odd pair. Is this other party they're waiting for me? It's kind of hard to imagine, isn't it? Nobody really knows any of the details of the deal, except for one person. Yep. Mr. Breeze Dancer in a white suit. They say he's been watching the movement of those two for a long time. Movements. I've never seen him work so frantically on an investigation before. Inspector Cadenela, hey? Apparently, you're a real favorite of his. A favorite? Yes, well, there's a reason for that. And what's that? Inspector Cadenela and Detective Yod were good friends. Yeah, I think I remember the prison guard saying something about that. They joined the detective division the very same day. They're two very different types, but they were always in friendly competition to be the best. Detective Yod was always very particular about the truly investigation of a crime scene. And Inspector Cadenela, well, I guess he just has a natural genius for investigating. Anyway, those two leads the detective division in those days. But Inspector Cadenela is different now. He changed a little. He changed ever since Detective Yod's incident. Now he distances himself from fieldwork. and he's starting to focus on nothing but moving up the ladder. And so that's how he became head of the Special Investigation Unit, I take it. Anyway, Inspector Cadenela took me under his wing. Because you were the little girl his good friend had saved, huh? He really looked at the helped me study for my detective exam. Punching my exam score for me. That goes a little beyond the scope of looking out for you. Inspector Cadenela, eh? I wonder what the role he plays in everything that's happening tonight. Camila. You sure it's taking Camila long enough? She should have been here by now. I'm getting really worried. You two are like sisters, don't you? That's what Camila said. Yep, that just about sums it up. It doesn't look like being worried affected your appetite much though. Hey, the bigger the crisis, the more I guess gotta eat. I have to make sure Camila stays safe, no matter what. Camila, and that music box too. Music box? Oh yeah, that wooden box. Yeah, I remember this. That box was a present from Detective Yard. From Detective Yard? Yes, it was 5 years ago. That box arrived 3 days after the murder incident. He must have sent it just before he was arrested. Someday, when the case is over and everything is settled, I want you to give this to a certain person, he said. So what's inside? I don't know, I can't open it. That's a shame. Sissel, did I really shoot you? Where did I come from out of the blue? I really don't remember. I tried and tried, but I just can't. Now I finally understand how you must feel. And how hard it is to have your memories gone, your story erased. But who knows, knowing the truth might be even harder. I rather believe there's a hope myself. That was great. Do I have chicken on my face? You're staring. I bet you think about how impressed you are with the way I took care of that chicken. Just tell me one thing. This case you say you're looking into, is it Detective Yowds? What if it was? I can't keep it from you. It's too cruel. Huh? What are you talking about? I'm sorry, Line. It's tonight. Detective Yowds, you know, it's tonight. It's execution. But there's still time. I look into it, and I found out all the executions in this country are carried out at dawn. That may be the norm, but not this time, I'm afraid. What? The execution is set for 11 p.m. What did you say? It's going to happen pretty soon. Isn't there anything we can do to stop it? Of course not, it's too late now. Not without the stay of execution from the Justice Minister. I'm going to go see him then. What? See who? Who else? The Justice Minister. Don't be ridiculous, there's not enough time. I'm going. Sissel. Me? Go to the prison, stop the execution. Easy enough for you to say. Detective Ringe, I'll be going now. Okay, I'll let you go this time. I tell them I was distracted because I was eating chicken. Is there anything else I can do? Could you find Camila? She's supposed to be on her way here. Oh, your little Camila. Okay. You got it. I'll look for her. Okay, you know what to do, Sissel. You have to save Detective Yowd. the life of yet another person is I'm connected to somehow is about to end tonight. Could it be a coincidence? Or is there something more behind it at all? Detective Yod is destined to be executed tonight. I don't know if that's fate is the wrong one for him or the right one. But I decided to go to the prison anyway. Yes, I would like to save. let's see. Do I have more time here? Yeah, I think I can manage to squeeze in. I do this before work, so yeah. Chapter 8. 10:55 PM. I went to try and rescue prisoner Dina Hattari, even under ordinary circumstances. That prison has a strange atmosphere. But this time there's something even stranger about it. An execution. With my memory gone, I don't have a clear image of what this is in my head. But even if I can sense the strong feeling of foreboding that hangs in the air. Maybe I'm too late. So how is this going with the generators in the basement? They're trying to fix it now. It's gonna take a while, they say. They haven't even gotten the internal phone there back up yet. I just hope their roadies don't rush the guards through. Oh, we don't have any roadies here. And what's more, the ones who committed the most atrocious crime isn't even here anymore at all. You promise not to talk about that. They could you knock it off with the weird flipping and flopping around? I can't stand looking at it. If you don't stop, I just might hit a pound you. This is the glorious dance that's been passed down in my family for generations. When you don't know what else to do, dance, dance, dance. We call it a panic dance. This is special detention calling from the death chamber. The internal phone is finally back up. It's pitch black down here. Tower until they get the generator going again. How's it going up there? The phone's been ringing off the hook from the headquarters. Oh boy, we can't let the existence of the prisoner become known to the outside world. We have to round up the prisoners somehow. Is Bailey dancing? Yep, you should see him. Take a video of it. We can all watch it together when we're done. Once the generator is back up, I'll record it with the security camera. Yeah. Cell phone cameras wasn't this common. So, generator still not up. I can't keep this up much longer. Believe me, nobody's asking you to. Why don't you just stop? Will you dance instead then? Me? You're kidding me! Somebody has to do it. I always dance it faster. If that somebody is me, I keep dancing until I drop. So, despite how it looks, this situation seems pretty serious. Bailey's dancing is certainly interesting. But that telephone call that came in is even more interesting. The man said he was calling from the death chamber, eh? Now that I have that extension number, I should go check it out. Yeah, that's probably my only choice anyway. Internal... Bro, said detention. Wait, what?